Opuntia stricta is a problem in Savo National Park because one, it is invaded thousands of hectares of land, and of course that has a negative economic bearing because it reduces the land available to livestock and wildlife. It's been with us for not less than 50 years. This greenhouse has been running since 2014. We have been continuously propagating the cochineals in this greenhouse and taking them out. From the results that we've seen, definitely science is playing a big role in this. The running cost for this biological control is quite small compared to if one was doing mechanical harvesting or using chemical to control the spread of Opuntia. I've seen homes where people have moved away because the Opuntia stricta has grown up to their doorsteps. So once this is controlled or eradicated, then it means that you are going to improve the socioeconomic status of the people.
The Opuntia stricta, which we just found near Lake Baringo, and Opuntia stricta is also present in the Serengeti district, or Serengeti region in Tanzania, and it's also sometimes common along the coast. We try to reduce the impact that the cactus is having. And in this case, we've introduced what they call a cochineal. It's a sap-sucking insect, and it's amazing. It's so specific, so it will only feed on Opuntia stricta, not on other cactus species. You know, no animals actually eat the cladodes, what do you call cladodes, which is like a modified stem, because it's got these big, nasty spines on them. So nothing eats that. So what happens is these species proliferate in the rangelands, and what they do is they start occupying more and more land, and so there's less grazing available for livestock and for wildlife. But what's also happening at the same time is that a lot of the livestock and even the wildlife like baboons and elephants are starting to eat the fruit. So the fruit has got quite a high sugar content and it's obviously quite tastier, probably to them tastier than grass, you know. So they start eating these fruits. But the fruits have got little spines on them, little thorns on them called glochids, like little barbs. And what happens is when the sheep and the cows and the goats eat these fruits, those little spines lodge in their intestinal tract, so in their stomach lining and in the intestine. And that those cause secondary infections. So you'll get, like in goats, for example, if you look at goats that have been eating cactus fruit, they have what they call pear mouth. You'll see their lips are really hard because of these little thorns that lodged in them. Look in their mouths will be full of abscesses and sores from these little thorns that have lodged in their mouths, because these thorns, through these thorns, the livestock get secondary infections and they die. And then also, you know, a lot of people eat the offal, you know, the intestine, stomach lining, but people don't eat that anymore because now it's full of pustules and little spines. So the work we've done and the socioeconomic surveys we've done and asking the communities what the impacts are, they're really significant. They've been doing a lot of work with school children, you know, getting school children involved in projects, getting them to breed the insect and understand biocontrol and release it in the field. So it started off with a community asking for help, and now the community are starting to solve their own problems by redistributing the biocontrol agent. And the impacts that we're seeing now in Laikipia are phenomenal. We're getting huge diebacks. The whole plants are dying back. And those plants that are only slightly infected already, we're seeing no flowering or food production.
Ili nijoin hii conservation club, wazazi wangu waliniambia kwamba ni vizuri niweze kujoin ili niweze protect wanyama yetu, sababu wengi wao tia pale wakienda kunywa maji na wanaweza kugongwa mdomoni wakienda kutafuta chakula. Ule mdudu pia tunamtumia aweze kukausha ile mmea ambayo ni Opuntia na inaweza kula pia matunda yake na pia kukausha ya mti. Sana sana si kukata, alafu tunachoma ama tunaweka juu ya mabati ili kauke tuweze kuitumia kama kuni,
sababu wakati naenda kuni hapa naingia manguo sinakuna masho mdomo Hata wangine umemaliza paka na naua kabisa. Namalisa kambusi yote. Ng'ombe kwa shida sana hiyo kitu. Naona ni mingi sana na kwa mingi kuliko nyasi. Wakati hii kitu najua iko nini. Iria hii karibu mwaka karibu 10. Hata sisi na sharibu kukata kwa mapanga. Na sidi tu umia sana. Mimi nataka kwa nini kuleta hiyo makitu, kuendelea nini, nafanya hiyo kitu, paka naendelea nini kukusha.
Sasa hata watoto wakichesa hapo, hata hawa watoto ya shule, kila wakati natolewa na wapeleka hospitali limeumiza, iko na shida sana. Na tuna hofu ya kwamba tutakuja kukosa mahali ya kuishi hapa, sababu hii kitu inaenea kwa haraka sana.